As part of a traveler's journey is to share his story, and this is my story of the Maasai Mara.
What is up, my good people? How you guys doing? Welcome back to another vlog. I'm here with Ravi.
Yo.
What's up? So guys, at the moment we're at the viewpoint,
Rift Valley
viewpoint, as you guys saw the time lapse. We're headed to Maasai Mara. So as you guys can see, it is super cold out here. I'm strapped up with this jacket. It's pretty warm. Ravi out here strapped up as well.
Yeah.
Sahil feeling like Rambo. So he's good.
Yeah.
You know, this time of the season is there's a lot of people going, as you can see behind me. All the cars you can see behind me, there's a lot of people traveling to the Maasai Mara. It's peak season.
Our driver was driving very fast, and because of that, we encountered a puncher.
So guys, basically we got a puncher before reaching the Mara. We got a small puncher, as you guys just saw the car. There's a puncher. We're in the basically in a small town in the middle of nowhere. But these guys are repairing the puncher, so yeah, let's wait and watch.
Then finally, we made it to the Maasai Mara National Park. The beauty of this place was unspoken of. The massive grasslands and the beautiful scenery made me feel out of this world.
Oh,
Guys, our car is stuck, as you can see over there. We're right next to the elephants. We're not supposed to be outside the park, but our car is stuck.
Finally, we saw the elephants, the gentle giants roaming the plains of the Maasai Mara.
So guys, our car stuck once again because of the puncture yesterday. Our wheels given up on us, the spare wheel that is, and now this is what's happening.
Oh.
Yeah.
Whoa, yay.
So guys, we made it out. We made it out. But this tire here is still gonna give us some problems.
Towards the end of the trip, we decided to visit a Maasai village where we met this Maasai man called Nelson, who showed us around. The Maasais are very good and humble people. Nelson showed us different plants that they use to keep mosquitoes away and how they make fire without using a light or any matchbox. Thank you. Finally, Nelson took us to his home. He showed us his home, where he lived with his parents. In spite of having such little, Nelson still maintained a smile on his face, which really humbled me.
Segena kika no la mo abada kata gala mola ibodi la mola kika.